So we'll just begin by becoming present on the mat. Press your hands and lift your sitting bones, and then just let your spine fall down, your brain fall into place. And just place your hands gently on the tops of your knees, and we'll just take a moment to focus, pull the focus inward. And just feel how the breath is moving through the body this morning. And gently open your eyes. So I thought this morning that we begin with some exercising and massaging. And I went hiking yesterday in Frontenac Park, and I had new hiking boots, so I woke up in the middle of the night with cramps in my legs. Interestingly enough, I had just read an article earlier in the week about how to get rid of tremulousness in the legs without having to get out of bed and standing on the floor. So you just take your legs out in front of you, and bring your ankles together. You can lean back on your hands so that you're sitting your spine straight, but you're nice and comfortable, so you're not worrying about working the core or the back muscles. You're just going to take the ankles in circles, and apparently when you move both ankles together like this, it exercises a different set of muscles than when you rotate the ankles far apart or separately. I did this last night about 2:30 and late came my way. Didn't have to get up and bounce around on the floor. And then you can just move in the opposite direction. And then take your heels about hip width apart and just press your toes toward the front of the room, and then curl your toes downwards. And then exhale and press the heels toward the window. And curl your toes in toward your body. And then press the toes, point to the front of the room, curl the toes down. And then press the heels and pull the toes in toward the body. And just once more. So pull one leg up toward your body, and then we're just going to hold the leg with the elbows like this. So this is similar to when we do that complicated thing, but it's a little bit less of a stretch. You can round your body forward a bit if you like, and then just flex your foot and gently rock the hip back and forth, and you might feel a pull down the side of the bent leg. You might feel a bit of a release across the lower back. Just gently opening the hip. And then let your leg down. And take the other leg, same way. And if you need to just hold like this, that's fine too. Gradually your hip will open and become a little more flexible. Just keep your foot flexed so you're protecting your knee. And then let your foot down. I'm going to take one foot and put it across your thigh, hold underneath your ankle if you like. And we're just keeping the ankle loose. We're going to take the hand and just use the hand to rotate the ankle in circles So the chair, hand is doing the work, not the ankle. And then turn in the opposite direction. And then bring a little bit of mobility into the foot, flexing it back and forward, gently. And then from side to side. And then you can move across the diagonal from bottom to top. And then the other diagonal from top to bottom. And then you can pick your ankle up and just let your ankle be really loose. Just give your foot a shake. Now we're going to locate the acupressure point on the bottom of the foot. So if you go between your second and third toe, slide with your thumb down below the mound of your toe, right in at the top of the sole of your foot. You'll find quite a tender spot. You can just press in here and hold for 10 seconds. Just move your thumb around until you find the spot that's quite tender, and just press and hold for 10 seconds. And then release. And then make a fist with your thumb. Take the small baby finger side of your fist and just tap on that acupressure point about 30 times. Make sure that your jaw is relaxed and that you're tapping with some firmness, but you're not hurting yourself. And then take your thumbs and massage your toes. You can usually do two toes at a time. And then massage the ball of the foot down to the instep, right down to the heel. And when you get to the heel, take the palm of one hand and just squeeze your heel. Release, and then take your thumbs and move along the instep up to the ankle and massage around the ankle bone. And then back up to the toes. And then just take both hands and sweep. Switch to the other side. Take your foot across. And then just begin by bringing some mobility into the ankle so that it's your hand that's doing the work, the muscles in the hand and wrist. Your ankle's totally relaxed. And then move in the opposite direction. Nice and slowly. We have a tendency to want to do this like we do everything else, which is really fast. It's a nice way to bring awareness to slowing down, becoming present on the mat. And then take the foot back and forth. And from side to side. And then move across both diagonals from the top to the bottom. Keep your foot flexed while you're doing this. And from bottom to top. And then take hold of your ankle and just let your foot be loose and flop it around a bit. Then take your thumbs and massage each one of your toes. You can open your toes from side to side, or you can scissor them back and forth. bringing some fresh oxygenated blood into the toes. And then massage down the toe mound, down the ball of the foot, down through the instep, down to the heel. And then when you get to the heel, just take it in the palm and squeeze. And once again, we'll locate the acupressure point. Sort of put your thumb between your second and third toe. Slide it down into the instep. Now that we've done a bit of massaging, it might be easier, a little bit easier to find that tender acupressure point. And just press. Pinky finger, just tap on that acupressure point, waking up your whole body by waking up the bottom of your foot. And then stop, and then you can continue massaging the instep, up the side of the instep, around the ankle bone. Take both hands and just squeeze the energy down. Sit on the mat and just place your feet on the mat, your hands behind your body, and then just gently lift your hips. Put your weight flat on your feet, and then come back to sitting. Take your legs out straight with your feet flexed. Now we're going to work on releasing the hamstrings, and we're going to use the concept that we looked at a couple of weeks ago called panniculation. So we're going to tense the muscle, lengthen it, and then release it. So bring your right leg in as close to your body as you can, and then reach down and take a hold of the instep of your foot. Now we're going to tense, tighten the muscles by inhaling, slightly arching the back, looking up toward the ceiling, and pulling the foot up toward the body. And then on an exhale, very slowly lengthen the leg. If your mat is really sticky, you might want to move onto the floor. Don't go too far. And then very gently pull the leg back in and release. So maybe try moving sideways on your mat so that your leg can move. Maybe slightly easier if your heel can slide. So once more, we'll pull the leg, the knee, bend the knee, pull it close to the body. Take hold of the bottom of the foot. Inhale, arch the back, look toward the ceiling, and then very slowly lengthen the leg. This time you might be able to go just a little bit further. Keep your chest on your knees so that your body is bending forward as well. And then when you get as far as you can bend this knee, slowly slide the heel back to the body. And then exhale. Release. We'll do that once more, and this time you can slide as far forward as you feel. See if you can keep your chest rooted on your thigh. So inhale, arch the back, pull the foot toward the body, and then slide the heel, slowly lengthening the hamstring as far as you want to lengthen. We go a little farther this time than the last time, and then come back And just release. Give your arms a little shake. Straighten the leg. And we'll move to the other side. So bend the left leg. Bring it close to the body. Slide your hands under the foot. Inhale, arch the back, look toward the ceiling. Pull the foot up toward the body. And then slide. Don't go very far, just slide a few inches. And then pause. And then come back toward the body. And release. Bring the foot down. And then once more, take the foot in your hands. Inhale, arch the back, look toward the ceiling, and very gently slide the foot out, keeping your belly on your leg. And you may find that you can stride just a little bit farther this way. And then slide the heel back toward the body. And relax. And third time, hold the foot, inhale, arch the back, look toward the ceiling, and slide. You can round the back. And then slide back toward the body. Release. Take both of your legs out in front of you and just give it a little tap. Back on the mat. The next pose we're going to do is called the swimming frog, and what we're going to want to do in this is make two different motions with the feet. So at one, we're going to keep the ankle on the floor, and one motion is going to be bending the knee and sliding the ankle like this. And then the other one we're going to turn so that the other ankle, and it's probably not going to go to the floor unless you're really flexible, and we're going to move out away from the body. So, to make it a little bit more pleasant, we're going to lie on the back. Take your legs out long. And separate your feet about hip width apart. And very gently roll the toes in towards each other and then roll them out toward the outer walls. And then once more roll them in toward each other and back out toward the outer walls, just opening in the hip area. Now bring your attention, your awareness to your right leg. Roll the right foot out toward the outer wall so that the ankle is close to the mat. And then bend the knee and slide the knee up toward the body. And then slide back down. Straighten both toes toward the ceiling and then let both toes fall out toward the outer walls. Bring both toes toward the ceiling. Turn the right toe out so the ankle is moving toward the mat. And then bend the right knee and slide the knee up toward the pelvis. And then back down. Point both toes toward the ceiling. And then let both toes fall out to the side and relax. Bring both toes pointing to the ceiling again. Turn the right foot out and slide the right knee up. And then slide the heel back down. Slide it up again toward the pelvis. And slide it back down. And then once more, slide up toward the pelvis. Slide back down. And let both feet fall out toward the side. And just take a moment to see if one hip, one side of your body feels lighter than the other. If one side is making a little bit more contact with the mat. Or if you feel a little lessening of pressure across the back of your body. Point both of your toes toward the ceiling, and this time turn the left toes outward and slide the left heel up toward body, bending the knee, and then slowly slide back down. Point both toes to the ceiling, and then let both feet fall out to the side of the mat. Let's take a moment to feel the energy moving through the lower part of the body. And then bring both toes pointing at the ceiling again. Turn the left foot out and slide, bend the knee, slide the heel up toward pelvis, and slide back down, slowly lengthening the muscle. Point both toes toward the ceiling, and then let both feet fall to the outside of the mat. Bring your feet so that your toes are pointing toward the ceiling, and then turn the left toes toward the outside of the mat. Bend the knee and slide on the ankle up toward the body and then back down. Slide up toward the body and then back down. And once more, slide up toward the body and then back down. And then let both feet fall out to the side of the mat. Take a deep breath and see if both of your hips have now returned to feeling even. And see if you're making a little bit more contact with the mat. Now we're going to bring both feet so that the toes are pointing toward the ceiling. And this time, the right leg, the toes are going to roll out toward the side of the mat, and the left leg, the toes are going to roll in. And then bring both feet back up to pointing at the ceiling. And this time, roll the left toes toward the outside and the right toes in toward the left heel. And then bring both feet so the toes are pointing at the ceiling. Walk your heels a little bit farther apart so they're a little bit greater than hip distance apart. Bring your awareness to your right foot and roll your right toes in toward the midline of your body. And now, bending your knee, slide your heel so that your knee is bending and your heel is moving up toward your hip. So you're in kind of a, if you want to look, you're in this position. And then slide back down. And let both feet flop out to the sides of the mat. And then once more, rolling the left or the right toes in toward the body and slide the heel up along the mat floor toward your hip. And you might feel a quite an interesting stretch. And then bring the leg back to straight. And once more, let both feet fall out to the outsides of the mat. So you're getting a nice release across the lower back. And then turn the right toes in toward the midline. And slide the heel up toward the body. And then back down. And relax and let both feet fall out. This time we'll turn the right toes in toward the body and we'll slide the heel up and then down, and once more up, and down, and up, and down, and then bring both feet to the outside of the mat, let your feet fall out, and just relax. Now turn the left toes in toward the midline of your body, bend the left knee and slide the heel, and then you'll semicircle up toward the hip, and then back down, and then let both feet fall out to the side. Once more, turn the left toes in toward the body, slide the heel, bending the knee, and then slide the heel back down, and let the feet fall out. And once more, turn the heels in, turn the toes in, and bend the knee, slide the heel up, and back down. And let the feet fall out to the side. Just take a moment. And then turn the left toes in toward the midline. And bend the knees, slide the heel up. And back down. Up. And back down. And up. Back down, and then just pause, let the feet fall out to the side. Exhale, and on the exhale, just gently press your lower back toward the mat. And as you inhale, feel how the lower back naturally arches slightly. And just take a moment to relax. Just slightly closer together, still hip distance apart. And this time we're going to turn the right toes to the outside, the left toes to the inside, bending both knees, slide both heels up so that both knees are moving together, and then slide both heels down. And let both legs straighten and the feet fall out to the side. Turn the left toes to the outside of the mat, the right toes in toward the body. Bend the knees and slide both heels up toward the buttocks. And then slide back down. And then bring both of your feet to your toes pointing to the ceiling. And then let both feet roll to the outside of the mat. Feel how this is opening in the hip area. Keeping the feet in the position they're in, with both toes pointing in opposite directions, both feet in opposite directions, slide your heels together so that your heels are touching one another. Your feet fall into the outside of the mat. Inhale and slide your heels up toward your pelvis. And then open your legs and slide the heels back down and around. And then once more, bend the knees. Bring the heels up toward the pelvis. You'll find a nice arch in the lower back. And slide. And imagine that you're a frog swimming through the water. And once more, slide the heels up. And then this time, bring the feet together. Both toes pointing at the ceiling.
And on the inhale, bend your knees and bring your knees right up towards your chest. Place your hands on your knees. And then just very gently make some small circles. And then make some small circles. And then lower your knees so that your feet are planted on the mat and your knees are pointing toward the ceiling. So you're going to move through some spinal flexes. So what we're going to do is, as we inhale, just feel your spine, your lower back rising into a small curve. And as you exhale, press your low back into the mat. Inhale, feel the spine curve, the body rise, and exhale, press the lower back into the mat. And once more, inhale, and then exhale, press to the mat. Go through that motion a couple of more times according to your own breath. And as you do this, see if you can sense into any other parts of your body that want to move along. Back to stillness. You may have noticed that your head and neck would like to become involved in this motion. So what we're going to do is, as you exhale and lightly press your lower back into the mat, tuck the chin down toward the chest. And as you inhale and create the curve, let your head bend slightly backwards so you're looking up. And exhale, look toward the chest. Inhale, look toward the ceiling. So you're very gently sliding along the back of your head, making a nice stretch to the neck, and also releasing some of the tension in the neck and shoulders. Keep your jaws soft, and just breathe through this motion according to your own breath. Flattening the back on the exhale, creating a slight arch and looking to the ceiling on the inhale. And then come to stillness. Straighten your right leg, straighten your left leg, turn your palms up to the ceiling. Tilt your chin just slightly toward your chest. Inhale, exhale. Feel your body sinking into the mat in a little mini shavasana. And then when you're fully relaxed and ready to move again, roll over onto your stomach so that you're lying flat on the belly. Bend your elbows so that your hands are out at the sides of your mat, so you're in kind of that cactus arm position. Slide your hands back so they're just a bit above the shoulders. roll your head so that your head is resting with your forehead on the mat. On the inhale, press into your hands, your elbows will lift up into the air, and lift your head off the mat. It doesn't have to be far. And then exhale, bring the head back down to the mat. Inhale, lift the head, and this time look to the left, look to the right, once more to the left, and to the right, back to center, and bring the head, forehead down to the mat. Let your elbows come down to the mat. Press your lower belly and into the mat. Soften your jaw. And exhale. Now take your left arm and bring it down beside your body with palm turned up to the ceiling so your arm is long. And bend the right hand, right arm, so that your hand is under your forehead. Perfect. Now turn your head so that you're looking at your right elbow, your left ear is resting on the palm of your hand. Walk your feet apart so that your legs are about hip distance apart, not too wide. Inhale, and on the exhale, just lightly press the right palm into the mat and lift your head up and down. And once more, just lift the head and down. And once more, lift the head and down. This time, keep your palm glued to the side of your head, and as you lift your head, lift your arm and palm along with it, and then down. Just a very small back bend, lifting up and down, and once more up. Turn your head to the center of the mat, bring your left palm on top of the right. Place your forehead on your palms. Inhale, and on the exhale, just relax and feel your whole body sinking into the mat. Relax your jaw. Feel a relaxation along the shoulders and down the back. You might feel a little bit more ease in the lower back area. Now slide your right palm out from underneath the left and place your right arm down along the body with the palm pointing at the ceiling. Turn your head so that you're looking at your left elbow, your right ear is on your palm. And then very gently inhale, and as you exhale, pressing lightly into your left palm, lift your head, and look at your elbow, and then lower the head. See if you can feel how, as once again you lift the head, this is moving all the way down the back, right down to your pelvis, down along the sacrum, lift the head again. And then let the head come down. This time when you lift the head, keep the palm, back of the hand glued to your ear. Lift and lower. Lift and lower. And lift and lower. And then bend the right arm back up. Place the right palm on top of the left. turn your forehead to press into the palms. Take your legs a little bit apart and turn the toes into each other. Inhale, and on the exhale, just let your whole body relax. And just take a moment to rest in crocodile pose. Slide your left palm out from underneath your hand, but take it into that bent elbow cactus pose, so it's bent up towards your head instead of lying along the body. So you'll see, just bend your left arm.
That's right.
Yeah. Take your left palm out toward the side. So you're just releasing a little bit of tension on the lower back. That's it. This will make this next move just a little bit easier. So turn the head, looking at the right elbow again. And this time, as you press into the palm and lift the head, also lift the left leg off the mat. And then back down. And point your left toe. Lift the head and the leg down. And once more, lift the head and the leg back down. And then this time, we'll keep the palm glued to the side of the head. So inhale and exhale, lift the arm and leg and down. And once more, lift the arm and leg and down. And then stack one palm on top of the other. Press your forehead into the back of your palms. And just take a moment to relax. And then slide the right palm out back into cactus pose. Turn the left ear, sorry, the right ear onto the left palm. And this time we're going to inhale, and on the exhale, lift the head and the right leg and back down. Then inhale up and down. This time, keeping the back of the hand glued to your head, lift your arm and leg and down. And we'll do that once more. Lift the arm and leg and down. Slide your right palm on top of the left. Turn your forehead into both palms. This time, pressing into the palms, we're going to very gently lift only a few inches, both the head and both legs. And back down. And once more, pressing the palms into the mat with the head and both legs. And down. Take a deep inhale, press the lower part of your abdomen into the mat, and just release and relax. Turn your head so that your right ear is resting on your palms. And then very gently pressing into your palms, lift your head and turn your head so that your opposite ear is resting. press into the palms and bring your forehead to your hands again. And then slowly roll over onto one side. So that you're lying on your side body. Bend the arm that's closest to the mat and make yourself a little pillow for your head. Bend your knees so that your knees are at a 90-degree angle from your body. Flex your feet so as if you're sitting in a chair. So straighten the lower part of your legs so that you're, yeah, just, that's right, you see, flex your feet. One of the first places that we start to lose mobility in the body as you age or as you become less active is in the side body. So we're going to work at strengthening the muscles in the side of the body. These are the muscles that contribute greatly to our balance, keeping us with a nice even gait when we're walking. So take your hand that's not under your head and place it in between your hip bone, your fingers in between your hip bone and your lower ribs. So you're feeling into your side body. Keeping your knees glued together, we're going to lift the top foot up and the thigh is going to kind of roll in toward your body. And feel as you, and then lower. Feel as you're doing this lifting and lowering, the muscles under your fingers contracting and pulling the femur up. You can see how much these side muscles are affected by the movement of the leg. And then bring your foot down on top of the other. You can take your fingers out of your hip and just give your hands a little shake. And then place your fingers back in between your hip bone and your ribs. And this time, we're just going to very gently lift the head off the arm and back down. So see if you can feel how your ribs are being pulled down toward your waist. And lift the head. And lower. And once more, lift. Now take your fingers out from between your hip and rib and take your arm up into the air. Bend the elbow so that you're holding on to your head just above your ear with your palm. Now we're going to combine both the lifting of the foot and the lifting of the head. We want to make sure we're coming in a straight line. So imagine that you're taking your armpit toward your hip. So inhale and then exhale, lift the head and the foot and back down. The head and back down. And once more, lift the head and then slowly back down. And Andrew Gilbert, keep your knees glued together and once more lift the foot. Perfect. And back down. And then gently roll over onto your back. Just take a moment to feel the difference between the two sides of your body. Does the hip on the side that you just exercised feel like it's making more contact with the mat? That there's a bit more release along the back?
And then we'll roll on to the other side. Make a pillow for your head. Bent arm. Bend your knees up so they're coming straight out of your body and your feet are coming straight down from your knees. Flex your feet as if you're sitting in a chair. And then take your other hand and place your fingers in that space between your iliac, your hip bone, and your ribs. Keeping your knees glued together, lift the top foot. Feel how the upper thigh is rolling in toward the midline of the body, and then lower. And just go through this motion 3 or 4 more times. Feel how the muscles in the side are contracting, pulling the femur, and then back down. This is actually part of the body that we don't stretch out too often. And then just come back down, take your fingers out, and give your hands a little shake. And then put your fingers back into that space. And this time, just very gently lifting the head and feel how the ribs are pulling and contracting. Lift. If you have your thumb around the back of your body, you can really get a sense of how hard these muscles are working. Much they like this kind of contraction and slow release. Now take your hand, raise your arm up, point your fingers to the ceiling, bend your elbow, and then take hold of your head with your hand. And then very gently lift the head and lift the foot. And once more, lift the head. And back down. And once more, lift the head. And back down. And then just roll over onto your back after the next. Keep your knees bent. And just see if you feel any looser, any more relaxed. Feel a little bit more relaxed along the shoulders as well as along the sacrum. And now straighten your legs out. Take your hands along the side of your body, just resting lightly on the mat. Flex your feet so your toes are pointing toward the ceiling. We're going to now work on relaxing and releasing a set of muscles that are very deep inside the body, very deep in the core. So it's going to be a very subtle movement. You may feel a little bit of movement, you may feel nothing, but something is actually happening deep in the body. So bring your awareness to your left foot, keeping your hips rooted on the mat. Very gently slide your left heel away from your body. And then slide back up toward your body. Again, slide your left heel out toward the window. And then slide it back. And once more, slide your leg out. And then let it release. This time bring your awareness to your right foot and begin to slide your right heel up toward your shoulder. And then back. So your leg is staying flat on the mat and you're just moving very deep inside the core. So using your awareness, slide. Hip is moving slightly up toward your shoulder and then back down. And once more, you're sliding your heel and then release.
So this time we're going to combine the two movements, and we're going to slide the left heel away from the body as we pull the right heel up. You may feel a slight movement in your pelvis, and then back to neutral. Once more, sliding the left heel out, and the right heel out. Once more, sliding. It doesn't feel like you're actually doing anything, but believe me, you are. So now we'll go switch to the other side. The opposite leg, push the heel away from the body, and place your hands on your abdomen to feel this if you like, and then bring it back to neutral. So tighten and push away from the body, and then bring the heel back to neutral. And once more, pushing the heel away from the body, and back to neutral. Then take the opposite leg, focus your awareness deep inside your core, and pull the heel up toward your shoulder, and then release it back down. Pull the heel up, and release. And once more, pull the heel up and release. And now put both movements together. Push one heel away from the body as you pull the other up and release. And push and pull and release. And once more, push and pull. Now just for fun, see if you can alternate these motions from side to side. So push the right heel down while pulling the left heel up. And then push the left heel down while pulling the right heel up. And move back and forth between this motion. And if it seems very familiar to you, this is the gait that you go through when you're walking. Bend your knees, bring your knees up to your chest, place your hands on your knees, and then just very gently rock from side to side along your sacrum. Come to stillness, let your right foot fall to the mat. Your left foot fall to the mat. Straighten out the right leg. Straighten out the left leg. Make sure your feet are a little bit greater than hip distance apart. Roll your palms of your hands up toward the ceiling. Let your feet fall out toward the outside of the room. And just inhale, exhale. Feel your back begin to settle down into more than that. Take your head gently from left to right, rolling slowly along the occipital bone. And then let your head come to stillness. Nose pointing toward the ceiling. Make sure that your chin is just slightly tucked. Relax your jaw. Relax the muscles around the eyes. Feel the relaxation moving from your eyes down your cheeks, down your jaw, down your chin, down under the chin to the neck. Feel Feel the neck relaxing along the front and the sides. Feel the back of the neck lengthening and relaxing. Feel your breath carrying the relaxation down the back of your body, down your spine. Feel the back of your heart pressing into the mat, opening and spreading wide. Feel the relaxation traveling down the spine to the hips and the pelvis. Feel your lower back and your hips and pelvis heavily sinking into the mat. Feel the relaxation traveling down the legs, down the back of the thighs, the calves, the heels, the whole of your legs relaxing and sinking into the mat. Feel how there's a relaxation in the front of the body, the torso and the chest are sinking back toward the mat. The heart is opening to the ceiling, and the energy is moving gently from the heart up along the collarbones, across the shoulders, down the arms, down the forearms, back of the hands gently sinking into the mat. On each inhale, the body relaxes, and on each exhale, the body sinks deeper into the mat. Feel your muscles completely relax. They don't need to support or hold you because you're being held and supported by the mat, as you're held and supported by the earth. Feel your breath moving gently through the body. Feel the energy that you created with the practice this morning integrating into your body and becoming one with each beat of the heart, with each inhale and exhale. You're more fully rooted and grounded within yourself, rooted onto the earth. Begin to deepen your inhale, fully exhale. Feel the breath bringing life and energy into the body. On the next inhale, feel the breath traveling right down to the tips of your toes. Begin to wiggle your toes. Make some small circles with your ankles. Feel the next in-breath bringing energy down the front of your body into your arms and begin to wiggle your fingers. You can clench and unclench your fingers gently. Let your head gently move from side to side. And then on the next inhale, bend your knees up to your chest. Wrap your arms around your legs. Give yourself a nice gentle hug of appreciation for the wonderful movement that you brought to your body this morning.
And then gently, when you're ready, roll over to your right side. Using your palms on the mat, press into the mat and bring yourself up to sitting. Bring your palms together at the center of your heart. Tip your head down toward your heart. Take a deep inhale. Exhale, raise the head. Thank you for practicing this.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.